Hi again, College Algebra Bros. Mr. C here, and I'm going to go ahead and show you how you can solve this equation, which will actually help us to verify which of these two solutions we got algebraically is the actual solution to the equation. So I have my graphing calculator up here, and let's go ahead and fire it up. I'll hit the on button, and let's go ahead and hit y equals. And with the way that the original equation is written, we got square root of x plus 7 equals x plus 1, I would recommend using the intersect feature. Of course, when you do the intersect feature, you're going to have to define two equations, so y1 and y2. And I typically let whatever is on the left-hand side be y1. So let's go ahead and type that in. We'll hit second x squared, and then x plus 7. Now, if by some off chance there was something on the outside, like following the square root symbol, all you'd have to do is hit the right arrow key. Now you're outside the square root symbol, and you can type in whatever you want there. But obviously, there's nothing directly to the right of this in our left-hand side, so we're just going to go down to y2 and type in x plus 1. And now hit zoom 6 to get the standard viewing window. There's y1, and there's y2. So as you can see, these two graphs are only intersecting in what appears to be one point. So that right there tells us that we should really only have one solution to this radical equation. And based on the location of the point of intersection, i.e. it's in quadrant 1, and any point in quadrant 1 has a positive x-coordinate, positive y-coordinate, you can probably tell that x equals 2 is the actual solution to the equation. We're not seeing any point of intersection that would have a negative x-coordinate, so we can probably tell just based on this negative 3 is extraneous. All right, well, let's go ahead and verify that x equals 2 is the actual solution via the graphing calculator. So we're going to go ahead and use the intersect feature now. Let's hit second trace, and it's going to be option 5. And what you can do is locate your blinking cursor back on your viewing window. And I'm just going to arrow it over to the general vicinity of where these graphs are crossing. You don't have to be pinpoint on there. As long as you're close enough, that's good enough for the calculator. And once you get your blinking cursor to where the crossing, or at least the general vicinity of it, you can go ahead and press enter 3 times. And there we have it. It says the intersection is at x equals 2, y equals 3. As an ordered pair, that'd be 2 comma 3. Okay, in terms of the solution, you could just write x equals 2.